Now, we're going to get down to the nitty-gritty of what Indians are all about.
I still say we Indian people are believers in the truth. This is the way of life that was given to your people. You're born an Indian, you're going to die an Indian. Indianness is a good life. You're facing an Indian this afternoon.
Good Saturday afternoon out there, everyone. Welcome to your number one source for Native American television news, Native News Today. I'm your host, Jason Salzman, here in the Muskogee Media Studios as we get ready for our next episode of NNT as we move on now, well over 500 episodes, moving towards 500 more here. We've got a great show lined up this week. Lots of things to talk about, and folks, we are in the month of June, which can only mean one thing, the 42nd annual Muskogee Creek Nation Festival coming up. Once again, this week, we're going to be talking festival, lots of things to do with the festival on our program. A little bit later on, we had a table, if you pay attention to our online channel and our MuskogeeMedia.com, the table is one of the series that's been very popular. We'll have a round table discussion on the festival, as well as after this very first break, we'll be back with the Interim Director of Tourism and Recreation, Mr. Brian Onhill, to talk about all the things coming up with this big event. Don't go anywhere.
Looking for your next 18-hole adventure? Then take a look at Fountainhead Creek Golf Club. Nestled in the beautiful confines of Lake Eufaula State Park, large sloping greens and well-placed bunkers characterize the Muskogee Creek Nation's Floyd Farley design course and offers a fine test of skill for any golfer. Stay up on all the latest gear and equipment with a visit to our pro shop. Have lunch at the turn at the Clubhouse Grill. We're waiting to accommodate you at Fountainhead Creek. Give us a call at 918-689-3209 or visit fountainheadgolf.com to book your next round. Fountainhead Creek Golf Club, close to home, far from ordinary.
And we're back in studio, now joined with Interim Director of the Tourism and Recreation Department, Mr. Brian On the Hill. And Brian, thanks so much for being with us today.
Thanks for having me.
Well, you know why you're here? We're talking about the 42nd Annual Muskogee Creek Festival, the show of shows here at the Creek Nation. It's happening this June, and I know you guys are excited about it. Talk about the planning and the lead up to this year's event.
Well, we always start about December planning for the festival, and people think, why do you start so early? Well, that's kind of late for us to plan such a huge event. You know, we have 30 to 40,000 people that show up over the course of 3 or 4 days. Lots of vendors, lots of participants, lots of tournaments. We have entry forms that are spilling in. Vendor forms were coming in February. We have a new splash pad at the Omniplex, so people are enjoying that right now. We're taking down the fence currently to put up a new fence, so we'll have new chain link for the Omniplex. We have replaced the stage roof so that we won't have any rain on our entertainers.
Great.
We have the entertainers in place, which took a while this year, and it's not our own fault, you know, sometimes we're at the mercy of those entertainers whenever we're waiting on them to sign contracts and things like that.
Yeah, we discussed that at the table yesterday, actually, the different dynamics of you all at your job, your team, what you go through leading up to a festival. And some of that is riders and contracts with the entertainment. We want to make sure and have a great experience for everyone to come out. So we want to get those great acts. And sometimes that takes a little bit of time as you talked about. And what's that experience like for you all? I mean, do you kind of just roll with the punches with it?
We have to. You know, there's some times whenever we can get into it and say, hey, we need this. You know, we're paying you for these things. We need you to turn in your contract. We're waiting on you. This is the insurance that we're providing. What else do you need from us? Where's your rider? What things do you need us to provide? We're not giving you any alcohol. Those kinds of things. And so we have to go back and forth through the AG and back to their lawyers and things like that. And Carmen Tiger and Ryan Logan work really closely with the entertainers, with our buyer and things like that. And so they're the ones that are really involved with that. And they kind of just keep me in the loop to things that are going on with them.
Yeah. Now, you've been with Tourism and Recreation for how many years?
This will be my 8th festival.
But this will be your first festival as the interim director kind of over the thing. So what's that been like for you? I mean, has it been sort of a seamless transition? I know you guys do everything as a team. So that's been nice, but has it been sort of a seamless transition?
It's been sort of a seamless transition. There is some pressure, some added pressure. There's some added stress, knowing that I am going to be the leader of the team and knowing that I'm trying to lead them into a successful festival. Mm-hmm. So I put a lot of stress on myself. Mm-hmm. I don't think that stress is coming from the team. Mm-hmm. I think it's coming just from myself, and I do that to myself because I'm a perfectionist, so I like things to be just right. So if something's going to be off, I'm going to blame myself and no one else, and I'm just going to take the blame for everything. Right. And hopefully the whole team will take will get the cheers for the success.
Exactly. I know that there is a lot that goes into it. Now, let's talk about some of the things that we can look for this year at the festival that are going to be maybe new, that people aren't accustomed to. Okay. Splash pad? Maybe?
Splash pad's going to be there. We're going to have lots of kids that are going to stay cool this year, as well as the adults. I know they're going to be joining in with the splash pad too. We have BJ Thomas lined up for us, Lee Greenwood, and we all like that song, the God Bless the USA. Oh, yeah. We know we're going to look forward to that. Also, we have Blues Traveler and the one and only Brett Michaels. Yeah. I know a lot of people are looking forward to that. I know a lot of people have called wanting to work that day or work backstage with him. We just have lots of fun things that are coming. We also have a guy that called us and wanted to set up a bubble tower. And so there's going to be like a continuous flow of bubbles. Cool. And I know that a lot of kids like bubbles. Oh, I know my daughter loves bubbles.
My daughter's nuts. I wish I liked anything as much as she liked bubbles.
There you go.
That's going to be great. Well, also, I think there's a tennis tournament coming.
There's
back.
A tennis tournament, yes. And it's going to be the week of the slow pitch tournament. Mm-hmm. So it'll be the week before the festival.
Yeah, and that's something to remember is that the festival is almost a month-long event.
Right.
I mean,
right.
It starts with the pageant, then we move on to other things. But it's like all June is festival.
It is. June 4th is the pageant. The next weekend is a golf tournament.
Yes.
And then the weekend after that's the tennis and then the slow pitch. Mm-hmm. And then following that's going to be the entire festival weekend starting on that Thursday, June 23rd.
I know, and you guys are very proud of your website that contains everything.
It has everything you need.
Yeah, creekfestival.com.
Remember it.
To stay up on everything. Forms, event dates, there's even a calendar with everything on there where you can see and pick and choose which things you want to go to, the days, there's a map, my goodness, right. It's got everything. Right. And if you cannot make the festival, that's what we're for. Muskogee Media out all day, all weekend, and we're getting photos, we're getting videos, we're getting live updates. Stay with MuskogeeMedia.com because that's going to be your connection. If you can't make it, we know everybody can't make the Creek Festival, but if you can't make it, that's really your way to get the experience of it without being there. Mm-hmm. So, and also check out the video that we did for them on creekfestival.com. It's right there on the site and you can watch that. And basically, if you don't know what the festival is, watch the video. That's the festival. So that's what we did it for. And Brian, thanks so much for being with
thanks
us.
Thanks for having me.
Appreciate you coming in. Creekfestival.com. This is going to be one of the best ones we've ever had. I know it.
We're looking forward to it.
Thank you guys so much for all the hard work you do.
Thank you. We appreciate it. Mm-hmm.
It's more than just an associate degree. It's a life-changing experience.
You'll see a lot of cultural features here on the campus. You'll see a symbol of the mound, which goes back to the history of Muskogee people as being in that Mississippian time period, that mound-building society. That really welcomes our students whenever they first get here.
The college in itself is beyond the building, is the people.
They're passionate, very passionate about what they teach, and it shows whenever they're teaching.
The instructors and the administration, they really believe in their students here.
After a couple classes, I began to notice that it kind of felt as if I were returning back to something that had been lost for like a long time. As I learned more about the history of my people, to discover that there were very many great people that did a lot of good things for their people, for their nations, and that those people were American Indian and Native American, it kind of brings out a sense of pride that was not really there before.
There is a future for our people.
And welcome back to the program. And I want to thank Brian on the Hill and all the great people at Tourism and Recreation once again for making the festival such a big event. And be looking for that on creekfestival.com, muskogeemedia.com, all things leading up to the big weekend next weekend as things get kicked off there with this Thursday Stomp Dance. Well, as I told you at the beginning of the show, we had another session of our popular web series, The Table. And we want to show you that to you now as me, as well as colleagues from here at Muskogee Media, discuss the festival and all the excitement surrounding it. And welcome into the newest installment of The Table here at Muskogee Media. And today, guys, I am joined with Sterling Cosper, Darren DeLon, and of course, Jessica McBride. We are talking about the show of shows here at Muskogee Creek Nation, the annual festival. 2016, this is number 42. Rolling up here, guys, and very excited, as we always are here at Muskogee Media, because I don't know if everybody knows this, but we're such a huge part of the festival as far as just being out there and bringing it to the folks that can't actually physically come. We're putting up pictures, we're putting up videos, we're trying to give everyone the festival experience. So it's honestly the biggest weekend, the busiest weekend of our lives every year. So we have a lot of work to do. First things first, though, an official letter out of the office of the principal chief this morning, James Floyd, indicating that before the Creek Nation has adopted 2 CFR Part 225 for allowable and unallowable costs for all programs per the comprehensive annual budget legislation. Now, to break that down in layman's terms, they basically said no more spending on promotional items, you know, t-shirts, stuff like that, giveaway, stuff like that. That's kind of difficult for the festival because that's a big part of it. Mm-hmm. Promotional items, the booths, the informational setup at the Omniplex. So the chief sends down an official letter authorizing tribal programs that set up booths at the Omniplex to purchase promotional items to be able to hand out at the festival. Crisis averted there. Actually, if you're a federally funded program, you have to look and into your respective agency whether you can get the promotional items too. So, but all tribally funded programs that have a booth set up out at the festival, same song, you know, as always, it's going to be promotional items and stuff like that. So, did anybody have anything to say about the letter that came down?
Well, it's a big deal for us, man, because this year we've done a rebranding. We also have our freedom of press to tout, so mm-hmm. It would have been an awful shame if we weren't allowed to do that.
Yeah, and we had a lot of things already planned for promotional. Mm-hmm. I mean, that was going to be really the biggest thing that we were doing this year at the festival was promotional.
Yeah, and I think it'll be interesting to see if this holds just for this year or what comes to be, you know, at next year's festival, right, too.
And I know Darren was disappointed. He didn't think he was going to get the plug-in chargers from the Department of Health or
that's
something
like that.
That's
what I was hoping for. Right, yeah, that's my go-to.
Go out there and get some of those promotional items. Okay, guys, the festival, as we say, there's so many different things that you can do, so many different events, some things new that were once old, as we talked about right before we came on air with some of the events, and we'll get into that a little bit later on. But we start off with this past weekend, the festival was actually kicked off. You look at it from a point of view of this thing goes all month, mm-hmm. and the first weekend of June, the scholarship pageants, we just crowned our new royalty for this year. And then it rolls on into the next weekend with the slow pitch softball, the 3-on-3 basketball. Hopefully we're bringing a 3-on-3 basketball championship to Muskogee Media.
Yes.
We'll have more as that unfolds. But anything you guys particularly look forward to each year? Jessica, we just announced the entertainment too. So that was something that we had waited on.
Yeah, I think everybody, from what I'm hearing, is really excited about the entertainment. Mm-hmm. On Friday night, we've got BJ Thomas and Lee Greenwood. And then on Saturday night, we've got Blues Traveler and Brett Michaels. And they're going to have fireworks shows after both nights.
Both nights. Okay, it's always been one night before. Mm-hmm. So both nights, that's neat. It's always good for us putting together the video, you know, getting that firework shot. So that's great there. What about you, Sterling? Anything that caught your eye as you look at the events or the way it's going to be handled this year?
Well, for me personally, what stands out every year as far as enjoyment's concerned is photography. And you talk about us reporting to the citizens that weren't able to attend, but also that's a big part of acting as a memento for those that were at the festival.
Right.
My two particular favorites and ones I like to shoot are rodeo and the bow shoot, because they present a unique challenge. Yeah. They're very fast-paced events, but they can generate some very stunning images.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but rodeo is usually the event that will produce even some award-winning shots,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, you always got to compete with those Navajo every year.
Oh, yeah, those Dene, I tell you what. What about you, Darren? Be taking some photos and stuff like that?
Photos, but really working the radio show on that Friday. And the reason why I said that is because we're going to switch your course from Wednesday to that Friday. We're going to be right there within the Claude Cox Omniplex. And I know we're going to do an opener, but then after that, like,
live
win
show.
A segment. Yeah, I got to gun it down to the Harmon Stadium for the Junior Olympics.
Junior Olympics, yeah. You've been a bit of part of that. I'm glad you mentioned that. Gary Fife, yourself, Muskogee Radio Show, doing a live remote from the festival. That's going to be a thing, too. As well as us. We're going to be doing some live shows and some shots in where we're going to be bringing people in, talking about the events as they unfold. Just sort of each year we try to go, how do we take it to another step, and how do we maybe bring more of the experience, as I talked about. And this year we have such a great forum for it with our new website and the newness of that and driving a lot of people to that. So it's going to be neat. Another thing, Jessica, every year in the past few years in October, around that area in the fall, I know we've had the big Hall of Fame ceremony. Mm-hmm. That's now gone. We're going back to Living Legends at the festival.
We've had, I've looked at several newspaper issues from the past. I mean, from the 70s, 80s, 90s, all up until now. And two things interested me. We used to have the Living Legends during the festival, and we also used to have a tennis tournament.
Yeah.
Both of those are back this year.
Yeah, the tennis tournament from like the grand old glory days of tennis in the 70s. You know, you had Jimmy Connors, McEnroe, Billie Jean King, you know, that whole golden age of tennis, Martina Navratilova, and then now you had the boom of tennis back in those days. I think it might have been Floyd Bells. I think he does a lot of the Native American tennis tournaments and stuff like that. And maybe he's the one that's coordinating this, bringing it back to Creek Nation. I'll have to look into that. I should probably know that. But that's neat, and I imagine it'll be here at the courts in Okmulgee, in the city, at the city park. So a lot of people around for all those sports and things like that. Live entertainment, as we said, just announced probably a week and a half ago.
Yeah, it was a little unusual this year, and folks are really starting to speculate as to maybe budget constraints or something like that, but it just turned out to be a last minute thing with contractual deal, and they ended up rolling them out, and we got in this last edition.
Somebody needed an entire jar of just green M&M's.
The
poor TMR crew over there. Yeah, the poor tourism recreation crew over there having to pick out every blue M&M, put it in here and jar in here. No, if anybody that out there knows and you work with entertainment, it's strange when you get into those contracts and some of the demands and things like that, and the delay of announcing. But Sterling, that's a great point, because we do hear, you heard all the chatter of, oh, there's a budget shortfall, and we're having to make, you know, tie up loose ends and everything with monies. We haven't heard anything. Maybe we won't get big time access. That is not the case. Blues Traveler, I mean, just from a personal standpoint, Blues Traveler, that's going to be a big draw. Not to say that any of the other ones won't, but they certainly have a niche, you know, audience and a crowd that's going to come
watch
them.
It's the 90s kids at the table.
Yeah, man, that's true. We all are. Yeah, not to age us at all. But, and, you know, Brett Michaels, certainly, hopefully he'll do some of his Poison stuff. But I'm sure a lot of it'll be, this is one off my new one, and everybody groans collectively.
Oh, right. He's no stranger to the acoustic guitar. But, those touring musicians can be something else. I'm sure they'll have no trouble.
Yeah. You know, we talk about the festival as a fun time as well. All the sporting events and stuff like that, as well as, you know, just the leisure activity itself. But really, I think it's meant to be more of like a homecoming where everybody comes together. From shooting, you know, and being out there and getting shots and everything like that. Do you kind of feel that that's the case? I mean, that's the kind of the feeling you get from being around everyone?
Well, Jessica, you did a people on the street type deal. That's right. Was that last year?
And a lot of people come in, you know, I had one family that came in for their family reunion. They schedule it around the festival every year.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah, and therein lies why we wanted to, once we found out who the talent was, wanted to give people as much notice as possible to make travel arrangements.
Right.
If that was kind of hinging on, well, are we going to be able to do this year? Do we want to go through the scheduling and all that?
Yeah.
So the more we can get out about it, as soon as possible, the better, I think.
Yeah, the 42nd year, you know, you think about that, that's a long time. The festival is older than any of us.
Yep.
And it started out as just a rodeo. It was just they wanted to do a rodeo, and they said, let's have an all-Indian rodeo. And then it, you know, just grew off of that. Then they said, let's start having softball games. And the softball games were at Henrietta, you know, at Reeves Park there. You know, it's evolved and developed with the nation's infrastructure, really, too, of building the Omniplex and making that a spot and the stage and everything like that. But, you know, just being a part of it from not only a citizen's perspective but also working it, it's weird because we don't really get the same experience working it because we're so busy, right?
Well, it seems like they've even made, like, structural changes every year.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they had the green room for the talent, like, 2 years ago, I think they added. This year we've got the splash pad.
That's so, right. Splash pad for the kids.
Exactly.
Have you taken the little one out there, the splash pad?
Cyan.
She's not the little one
anymore. I doubt it. She'd rather go to, like, swimming pools instead of, like, having water.
She's over the splash pad.
I think she's over all that. Yeah. But it's very popular. It got pretty popular pretty quick.
We saw people out there today, and I was like, why didn't you just wait till it rained?
You're going to have a hard time keeping me away from that towards the end of this.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
He's still going to go,
Pushing little kid down.
Keep the bandana wet.
Yeah, that's right.
Make sure you got it cooled off. It's going to be hot, I think. I mean, what's scary to me is it's going to just be muggy and rain coming through this whole month, and then it kind of just bakes you. But people that come to the festival know what it's all about. You're either going to get rained on or you're going to be extremely hot. I mean, there's your two choices right there. So
everybody
out there, stay hydrated. You know, remember to bring water with you. There's plenty of places out there to get something to drink, something to eat, things like that. But make sure you bring something with you, because you just never know whenever you're going to need, you know, a quick drink of water or something like that to keep you hydrated.
I don't know if they're going to, I have to confirm this with emergency management, but at one time they did have those cool tents.
Right, yes, they got the cool tents out.
At the entrance of the Omniplex.
Those will be out again for sure, and they have a medical personnel team on hand, ready and willing for anything like that. And also a light horse presence. Last year we saw the mobile command unit out there. We even did a story. We talked with them about it.
That was another new feature last year.
In response to some of the security issues that we had in the previous year.
Yeah.
And I believe that, you know, that they felt like that was sort of a good fix to that. Of course, you can't, you know, In anything where there's a large crowd, you're never going to be able to stop or prevent things from, you know, just sort of cropping up in different spots or things that are, you know, people aren't going to want to be a part of. But at the same time, if you can have that presence out there, I think it kind of shields it a little bit or at least, you know, deters that kind of behavior a little bit. So that's great. Want to remind everyone out there, creekfestival.com, www.creekfestival.com. That will give you everything you need. It will give you a lineup of the events. It will give you a calendar to look at the days that they're on so that you can plan. It will also give you times. It will give you forms to fill out to get in some of these events. So it's basically got everything you need right there on that site. We on MuskogeeMedia.com, we will have a lot of information for you there as well. Of course, you're watching us here on the table. You'll get a lot of information that we're putting out. And so it all gets started, as we said, this past weekend. It got kicked off with the scholarship pageant. Moving on to this next weekend, we'll be having the golf tournament, slow pitch softball, basketball. And then, guys, we didn't even talk about it. The Thursday night, when the official festival starts, the festival weekend, the Stomp Dance kicks everything off. And there's always a great crowd, you know, evidenced by the fact that they always run out of food. You know, I think I've been the last 3 years and I haven't got to eat one time. So if obviously still bitter about it, you know what I mean? So, but I don't know. I mean, I know you guys probably will have somebody out there pay for presents at the Stomp Dance.
Yeah, Stomp Dance is a big deal for us. If you haven't noticed, our masthead has consistently been Stomp Dance photos from last year.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a big deal. It's kind of, if we had to pick one image that encapsulates the whole event, it's probably going to be that one.
Yeah, and look for the old helicopter out as well this year. That's when we get a lot of our helicopter shots and stuff like that. And I would say, you know, just if we have an audience now, that if you come out and you see us with the helicopter, you know, yes, look at it. I mean, I know it's not normal to see somebody flying a helicopter around or something like that, getting the shots, the drone shots, but if you could not, you know, come stand directly under it and everybody point up, you know, all the kids, it's a tough, you know, to do because, you know, you never know. I mean, it's technology, it can fail, and that thing weighs a lot, you know, and it falls from the sky. You know, we're not going to be responsible for accidents or anything like that.
Well, I think the first year you guys had out, what was it, like 2 years ago, right?
Yeah,
hopefully folks are a little more acquainted and used to seeing drones.
I think drones have become a little bit more, not such a novelty now, you know, not such a, oh my gosh, I've never seen one. So, and hopefully, you know, we've seen other people come out there with them as well, that shoot and things like that, so.
Also, you folks, mind our airspace.
Right, yes. Yes, see the regulations on theskogymedia.com about airspace. No. But it's all going down, Claude Cox Omniplex. You do not want to miss this year's festival. The 42nd year happening in Altmulgee, one of our biggest events of the year, the biggest event of the year, if you talk about just in grand scale and size and just everything going on at one time. So it's going to be a lot of fun. As I said, already kicked off with the pageant, but really everything starts that Thursday, June 23rd. That's when we have the big festival weekend kicks off on all throughout that weekend. And there'll be the only thing happening on the last day, Sunday, will be the remainder of the Fast Pitch Tournament. And a lot of people watch that too. So keep it with us, MuskogeeMedia.com, and keep it with CreekFestival.com for all things Muskogee Creek Nation Festival in its 42nd year. Guys, thanks for talking about it today with me. And rapping a little bit about all that goes on. I know some of us are excited. Some of us dread it. No, I'm just kidding. No. Some of us go, oh, man, I am not going to be able to take 5 minutes to just kind of collect myself. That's not true. I'm exaggerating just a little bit. There's times where we can kind of go get a turkey leg or something like that or whatever. Turkey leg?
Turkey leg.
All right, good.
Yeah.
Lean meat, right?
Very
good stuff. All right. Well, guys, thanks for being with me talking about the festival. And we will have, as I said, keep it with MuskogeeMedia.com, CreekFestival.com. Until next time, this has been The Table. And that'll wrap us up here on Native News Today for this week. We want to thank all the great people that made it happen. Mr. Brian On the Hill, the interim director there at Tourism and Recreation, as well as all of my colleagues joining me on the table, Darren DeLon, Jessica McBride, and Sterling Cosper here at Muskogee Media. Want to remind you folks out there, festival weekend's coming up. The Thursday night Stomp Dance gets kicked off, everything kicked off, and then of course on into the weekend with the entertainment Friday, Saturday night, and then finishing up with the end of the Fast Pitch Softball Tournament on Sunday. So there's something for everybody. Go to creekfestival.com to see all the events and see what you want to attend. Everybody out there, keep it with muskogeemedia.com as well. We're putting up content daily, new videos, new stories, new content, so you want to check it out and stay with us on our online channel as well as all of our social media sites as well. Native News Today, Muskogee Nation News on your Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and as well as Muskogee Media itself, the brand. So everybody out there, have a great week. Have a wonderful festival weekend. We'll see you next time here on Native News Today.